one of the wrong assumptions I see people doing when I teach, and I have been seeing throughout these 2.5, 3 decades teaching the out-of-body experience and how to sense subtle energies, how to control your energies, how to sense the multidimensional reality. All the time, what I observe is that people who have already had a previous experience, they create inside of themselves like a framework of how their experience will develop, either in terms of how they will sense their chakras and their energy, or how they will sense the disconnection from the body in an out-of-body experience, or what's going to be the sequence of different events and phenomena that they may experience until they detach from the body. That's a big problem, because sometimes the way your experience, let's say the astral projection, will develop in that given session you are doing may be completely different. There are many factors that are involved in that. Just as examples, how loosened your energy field is, meaning the energetic interface, the energy that connects your physical body to your non-physical astral body. So it will make great difference on how easily you detach and how you feel it, what type of sensations you will have. But also, if during the day you have had any contact with people and you received some energies, which is natural, but you remained with some residues of those energy, this will interfere or affect how your experience, the out-of-body experience, will develop, how easily you are going to detach. If that is going to be denser sensations, if the energies are denser, if they are more subtle, what sort of perception you will have. So they will always be different. Sometimes there are people that, in a given experience, and there is a case of a student that I am remembering right now, that they had an experience in which he saw like some shapes, geometric shapes and colors, and he just got into that until he had a lucid out-of-body experience. Okay. Then, years later, he's practicing a technique. He's with us in the class, and we are guiding an exercise to leave the body. And he couldn't, but he was very close to leave the body. He had all the right energetic conditions based on what he described and what we could see. He had the right physical conditions, but he couldn't, because then he told us, in his mind, he kept all the time looking for the same images he saw, the same patterns, as if he had to see that, because necessarily that was what would guide him outside the body, or impulse him to detach from the body. So this is a very common misconception. Of course, because the sensations we have experienced in our previous projections, lucid projections, will now be very strong inside of us. And when the sensation was nice and the projection was nice, great. We think that's how it's going to happen. Not necessarily it is. But sometimes the projection was mixed with some fears, maybe we didn't have enough knowledge. And then again, when you observe, it's about to start, you have same reactions as if you are getting ready to something not so pleasant, as in the past have happened. Please bear in mind that the more you can completely let go of the expectation of the sensations and the process that will be related to that given experience, the better it will be. It does not mean you will let go of what you have learned, of your experience. That is valuable and you need to understand what happened. But assuming that's what is going to happen in that given session or technique you are practicing, then that's not favorable. That will end up reducing your chances of leaving the body. So keep an eye for that.